This is part two. This electronic lecture is directed to third year department of English. She Stoops to Conquer starts off with a prologue, but we are going to skip on that so as to spare some time. The play starts with Mr. and Mrs. Hardcastle conversing about something. Mrs. Hardcastle wants to go on a trip to town. Mr. Hardcastle undervalues her desire to go because he is like a strict old-fashioned man, whereas Mrs. Hardcastle wants to live this contemporary life, the frivolities of contemporary life. So let's read this dialogue between them. Through this dialogue we can infer some traits about Mr. and Mrs. Hardcastle. Mrs. Hard: A. Your time were fine times indeed. You have been telling us of them for many a long year. Here we live in an old rambling mansion that looks for all the world like an inn, but that we never see company. Our best visitors are all Mrs. Otfish, the curate's wife, and little Cripplegate, the lame dancing master, and all our entertainments, your old stories of Prince Eugene and the Duke of Marlborough. I hate such old-fashioned trumpery. So through this you can infer that Mrs. Hardcastle likes to live modern life, and she complains about the condition of her house and also the limited stories that she is introduced to, as well as one kind of visitors, old friends that are coming into her house. So she wants to see new faces and that stuff. Mr. Hardcastle: And I love it. I love everything that is old. Old friends, old times, old manners, old books, old wine. And I believe, Dorothy, taking her hand, you will own I have been pretty fond of an old wife. So from this we can infer that Mr. Hart is a very traditional man. He is conventional in his thoughts and desires and etc. From the very beginning, we get to know that Mrs. Hardcastle was married once before to Mr. Lumpkin, and she has a son with Mr. Ton Lumpkin, and the son lives with them as a stepson to Mr. Hardcastle. So these are some characteristics of the son. His name is Tony Lumpkin, and he makes a lot of jokes. He's a very funny, very, very funny character. You are going to enjoy his company, if you will. Tony is not educated, and both Mr. and Mrs. Hardcastle look down on education, especially his education. Okay, Tony likes to hoax. He likes to make pranks on other people, on the maids and animals, and even on Mr. Hardcastle himself. He has a very funny scene in the very beginning. Of course, narrated by Mr. Hardcastle. So let's see, Mr. and Mrs. Hardcastle speak of his education. Mrs. Hardcastle: And am I to be blamed? The poor boy was always too sickly to do any good. A school should be his death. When he comes to be a little stronger, who knows what year or two Latin may do for him. Mr. Hard: Latin for him? A cat and fiddle? No, no. The alehouse and the stable are the only schools he will ever go to. So from this dialogue from Mr. Hardcastle's turn, we get to know that Tony goes a lot to the alehouse and to the stable. So Tony spends his time at the stable, and at the ale house where he gulps glasses of liquor. As they speak of him, he passes through the stage, and we see that Mrs. Hardcastle implores him to give them company, to stay with them, to talk with them, but he actually refuses because he has to meet up with his friends, and all her begging is in vain. Mrs. Hardcastle here says, "You shan't venture out this raw evening, my dear. You look most shockingly." Tony, "I cannot stay, I tell you. The three pigeons expect me down every moment. There is some fun going forward." We see by three pigeons, he means his three friends that he drinks with. Then we get introduced to Miss Hardcastle. Miss Hardcastle is Mrs. and Mr. Hardcastle daughter. Her name is Kate. And at the very beginning, we see that Mr. Hardcastle informs her that he has chosen a husband for her, and she is going to meet that husband today at their mansion. The husband is called, or the chosen boy is Mr. Marlowe, the son of Charles Marlowe, who is one of Mr. Hardcastle's friends. So he gives her some characteristics of and qualities of this chosen husband, such as he is very handsome, reserved, young, brave, and he was born a scholar. So you can see from these qualities that he is also an aristocrat, or at least belongs to the upper class society, as well as the Hardcastle themselves. So let's see this dialogue between Miss Hart and Mr. Hardcastle. Miss Hart, "You have frozen me to death again. The word reserved has undone all the rest of his accomplishments. A reserved lover, it is said, always makes a suspicious husband. Mr. Hart, on the contrary, modesty seldom resides in a breast that is not enriched with no nobler virtues. It was the very feature in his character that first struck me." So before I end this lecture, I want you to really read this text, to enjoy the dialogue, how the dialogue is phrased. The language is not hard. You can understand the language. Of course, you have to look up some words in the dictionary, but it is really accessible, if I may say. The characters are really enjoyable. Enjoy Tony's jokes. He is going to make a lot of jokes, and they are so funny. I laughed a lot when I first read the text. If you have any questions, I am going to make a post on Google Classroom. Stay well.